Hello students, how are you? Again, welcome to my class. Now today, we will discuss about some problems from exercise 1.2. In this class, first we will discuss about question number 8. A student multiplied 7236 by 65 instead of multiplying by 56. By how much was his answer greater than the correct answer? My dear student, in this question, student want to find out the product 7236 and 56. In this question, student want to find out the product of 7236 and 56, but instead of 56 he wrote 65. That means instead of 56 student wrote the 65. So in this question, first we will find out wrong answer, then we will find out correct answer. Wrong answer means wrong product and correct answer means correct product. So in this question, first we will find out what is the wrong product of 7236 and 65. Now look here, 5 6 are 30, this is 0, carry over is 3, 5 3s are 15, 15 plus 3, 18, this is 8, carry over is 1, 5 2s are 10, 10 plus 1, 11, this is carry over is 1, 5 7s are 35, 35 plus 1, 36, okay. Then we will find out 6 6 are 36, this is 6, carry over is 3, 6 3s are 18, 18 plus 3, 21, this is 1, carry over is 2, 6 2s are 12, 12 plus 2, 14, this is 4, carry over is 1, 6 7s are 42, 42 plus 1, 43. Then after we will add these two natural number, this is 0, 8 plus 6, 14, this is 4, carry over is 1, 1 plus 1, 2, 2 plus 1, 3, 6 plus 4, 10, this is 0, carry over is 1, 3 plus 1, 4, 4 plus 3, 7, and this is 4. So, in this question, what is the wrong product? 4,70,340. 4,70,340 is wrong product of 7,236 and 65. Okay. Then after we will find out what is the correct product of 7,236 and 56. We will discuss. 6 6 are 36, this is 6, carry over is 3, 6 3 are 18, 18 plus 3, 21, this is 1, carry over is 2, 6 2s are 12, 6 2s are 12, 12 plus 2, 14, this is 4, carry over is 1, 6 7s are 42, plus 1, 43. Okay, again I will explain. 6 6 are 36, carry over is 3, 6 3 are 18, 18 plus 3, 21, this is 1, carry over is 2, 6 2 are 12, 12 plus 2, 14, this is 4, carry over is 1, 6 7 are 42, 42 plus 1, 43. Okay. Then after we will find out product of 5, 6 is 30. This is 0. Carry over is 3. 5, 3 is 15. 15 plus 3, 18. This is 8. Carry over is 1. 5, 2 is 10. 10 plus 1, 11. This is 1. Carry over is 1. 5, 7 is 35. Plus 1, 36. Okay. Then after we will add these two natural number. This is 6, 1 plus 0, 1, 4 plus 8, 12, this is 2, carry over is 1, 3 plus 1, 4, 4 plus 1, 5, 4 plus 6, 10, this is 0, carry over is 1, 1 plus 3, 4. 4,05,216. This is right product or this is correct product. And 4,70,340. This is wrong product. According to question, then we will find out what is the difference between wrong product and correct product, or what is the difference between wrong answer and correct answer. Let us, we will discuss. This is wrong number and this is correct number. As you are looking, wrong answer is greater than the correct answer. Wrong answer is greater than the correct answer. So what we will do? Correct answer we will subtract from wrong answer. Correct answer we will subtract from wrong answer. As you are looking here, 4,70,340 minus 4,05,216. Okay, now let us, we will discuss about what is the subtraction. This is 6 and this is 0. We cannot subtract 6 from 0. So what we will do? We take one number borrow from 4. So 4 converted to 3. 4 converted to 3. Okay, and this 0 converted to 10. 10 minus 6, 4, 3 minus 1, 2, 3 minus 2, 1, okay, this is 5 and this is 0. We cannot subtract 5 from 0. So what we will do? We take one number borrow from 7, then 7 converted to 6 and 0 converted to 10. 10 minus 5, 5, 6 minus 0, 6, 4 minus 4, 0. So, what is the difference between wrong answer and correct answer? That is 65,124. 65,124. This is required answer for this question. 65,124 is difference between wrong answer and correct answer. Okay. Again, my dear student, now let us, we will discuss about question number 9. To stitch a shirt 2 meter 15 centimeter cloth is needed. To stitch a shirt 2 meter 15 centimeter cloth is needed. Out of 40 meter cloth, how many shirts can be stitched and how much cloth will remain? To stitch a shirt 2 meter 15 centimeter cloth is needed. Out of 40 meter cloth, how many shirts can be stitched and how much cloth will remain? Okay. My dear student, now let us we will discuss about what is the procedure for this type of question. According to question, cloth required to stitch one shirt. Cloth required to stitch one shirt is 2 meter 15 centimeter. Okay, 2 is in meter and 15 is in centimeter. So what we will do, for easy calculation, meter converted to centimeter. Okay, and you know very well 1 meter equal to 100 centimeter. Then after 2 meter is equal to 2 into 100 centimeter plus this is 15 centimeter. 2 into 100, it will give to you 200 plus 15, 215 centimeter. The meaning is cloth required to stitch one shirt is 215 centimeter. Okay. Now in this question, what is the total quantity of cloth? What is the total quantity of cloth? Or what is the total length of cloth? Total length of cloth is 40 meter. Okay. And now look here, we will apply the same procedure, meter converted to centimeter. 40 into 100, it will give to you 4000 centimeter. Okay. 4000 centimeter is total length of cloth. Now look here, in this question we will find out how many shirts can be stitched out of 4000 centimeter cloth. So what we will do, for this question we apply unitary method. Now look here, cloth required to stitch one shirt, that is 215 centimeter, and total length of cloth is 4000 centimeter. Out of 4000 centimeter of cloth, how many shirts can we stitch? Now look here, so what we will do, the number of shirts can be stitched. Number of shirts can be stitched is equal to 4000 divided by 215. Number of shirts can be stitched out of 4000 centimeter will be 4000 divided by 215. Okay. Then after we will discuss about number of shirts can be stitched will be 4000 divided by 215. Now let us we will discuss about what is the procedure of division. Now look here, 215, this is divisor, and 4000, this is dividend. Okay, now look here, this is 2, this is 4. 2 1 are 2 and 2 2 are 4. I think 2 is not here, 2 will be not here. So which number will come here? That is 1. 215 into 1, 215. Okay. After subtraction, we cannot subtract 5 from 0. So what we will do? We take one number borrow from 0. But 0 would not give any one number. So what we will do? We go to the next number. Next number is 4. So we take one number, borrow from 4, then 4 converted to 3. This 0 converted to 10. Okay. Again, this is 5 and this is 0. We cannot subtract 5 from 0. So what we will do? We take one number, borrow from 10. So 10 converted to 9. 10 converted to 9. Okay. And this 0 converted to 10. Clear? 10 minus 5, 5. 9 minus 1, 8. 3 minus 2, 1. Okay. Now what is the next number? 0 is the next number. We can note down the next number is 0. Again, this is 2 and this is 18. All are know about the table of 2. 2 9 ja 18. 2 9 ja 18. Let us, we will discuss 215 into 19. Now look here, 215 into 19. 9 5 ja 45, this is 5. Carry over is 4. 9 1 ja 9. 9 plus 4, 13. This is 3. Carry over is 1. 9 to the 18 plus 1, 19. 1 9 3 5. And this is 1850. That means 1935 is not possible. So what we will do? Which number is nearest less 9? That is 8. That is 8. Let us we discuss 215 into 8. 8 5 ja 40. This is 0. Carry over is 4. 8 1 ja 8. 8 plus 4 12. This is 2. Carry over is 1. 8 to the 16 plus 1 17. 1720. 1720 will be here. So this is 8 and this is 1720. After subtraction, you will get 0 minus 0, 0, 5 minus 2, 3, 8 minus 7, 1. So, according to question, number of shirts can be stitched. How many shirts can be stitched out of 4000 centimeter of cloth? That is 18. 18 shirts can be stitched. 18 shirts can be stitched. And your next part of question is how much cloth will remain. The meaning is 130 centimeter. 130 centimeter of cloth will remain. Now look here. Number of shirts can be stitched. Answer is 18 shirts. Eighteen shirts can be stitched. And how many cloth will remain? Answer is 130 centimeter. 130 centimeter or 1 meter 30 centimeter. Both are same. 130 centimeter. Or 1 meter 30 centimeter cloth will remain. Okay. 18 shirts can be stitched out of 4000 centimeter of cloth and 130 centimeter or 1 meter 30 centimeter. Cloth will remain. This is the required answer for your required question. Again, my dear student, now let us we will discuss about question number 10. Medicine is packed in boxes. Medicine is packed in box X, each weighing 4 kg 500 gram. How many such boxes can be loaded in a van which cannot carry beyond 800 kg? Now look here. Medicine is packed in boxes, each weighing 4 kg 500 gram. How many such boxes can be loaded in a van which cannot carry beyond 800 kg? My dear friend, in this question we will find out how many boxes can be loaded in a van. So what we will do? This question depends on the question number 9. In both questions we will apply same method. As you are looking here, in question number 10, the weight of one box, the weight of one medicine box is 4 kg 500 gram, okay? 4 kg 500 gram is weight of one medicine box. So what we will do? Kg converted to gram. 1 kg equal to 1000 gram and this is 500 gram. 1000 into 4, 4000 plus 500, it will give to you 4500 gram. 4500 gram is weight of one medicine box, okay? And maximum load can be loaded in a van. Maximum load can be loaded in van, that is 800 kg. And kg converted to gram, 1 kg equal to 1000 gram. 800 into 1000, it will give to you 8 lakh gram. 8 lakh gram. So, maximum load can be loaded in a van is 8 lakh gram. According to question, we will find out how many boxes can be loaded in a van. How many boxes can be loaded in a van? It will give to you 8 lakh divided by 4500. 8 lakh divided by 4500. So number of boxes will be 8 lakh divided by 4500. Now we will discuss about what is the quotient for this question. This is dividend and this is divisor. Now look here. This is very easy division. This is 4. This is 8. 4 1 ja 4, 4 2 ja 8. 4 1 ja 4, 4 2 ja 8. 2 is possible. 4500 into 2. 4500 into 2, it will give to you 9000. 9000 is not possible. So we take here 1. 4500 into 1, it will give to you 4500. 0 minus 0, 0, this is 0. We cannot subtract 5 from 0. So what we will do? We take one number, borrow from 8. Then after 8 converted to 7. And 0 converted to 10. 10 minus 5, 5. 7 minus 4, 3. Okay? Again we will apply next number is 0, this is 0, okay? This is 4500 and this is 35,000. Which number will come here? Now let us discuss. This is 4, this is 35. You know very well, 4 8s are 32, 4 8s are 32. Now let us discuss 4500 into 8, 8 into 0, 0. 8 into 0, 0, 8 5 is 40, this is 0, carrying over is 4, 36,000 is not possible. So what we will do? We take one less number from 8. 1 less 8 is 7. There will be 7. Okay. 4500 into 7. Now let us discuss. 7 into 0, 0. 7 into 0, 0. 7 into 0, 0. 7 5s are 35. This is 5. Carry over is 3. 7 4 is 28 plus 3, 31. 31,500. Okay. Again, 0, 0, 10 minus 5, 5, 4 minus 1, 3. And now look here. Then after what we will do? Minus 31,500. It will give to you 3,500. We note down next number. This is 0. Okay. We apply the same procedure. This is 4 and this is 35. 4 7 ja 28. 4 7 ja 28. And 4 8 ja 32. Now look here. 4500 into 8. It will give to you 36,000. Okay. 36,000 is not possible. Again, we take 1 less 8. We take 1 less 8. That is 7. 4500 into 7. It will give to you 31,500. So, 31,500. After subtraction, you will get 0 minus 0, 0. This is 0. 10 minus 5, 5. 4 minus 1, 3. All are know about what is the subtraction. 3500 is remaining. And what is the quotient? 177. So, my dear student, in this question, your question is, how many boxes can be loaded in a van? How many boxes can be loaded in a van? Answer is 177. 177 boxes can be loaded in a van. Your required answer is 177 boxes can be loaded in a van. Okay. 177 boxes can be loaded in a van. Okay. My dear students, all these questions depend on your book from exercise. I hope that it will be very useful to you for your knowledge and upcoming exam. Thank you. God bless you.